हेलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ डॉक्टर शुभ अरोड़ा, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर फ्रॉम डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ कॉमर्स, जिम्स, ग्रेटर नोएडा। आई वंस अगेन वेलकम यू ऑल बैक टू द लेक्चर सीरीज ऑफ द सब्जेक्ट एडवर्टाइजिंग एंड ब्रांड मैनेजमेंट। करंटली वी आर ऑन द थर्ड यूनिट ऑफ दिस सब्जेक्ट एंड टुडे इज़ द सिक्स्थ लेक्चर। The topics which we are going to discuss in today's lecture are, we'll be talking about brand loyalty, the meaning, its definition and concept, and we'll also be talking about the various measures of brand loyalty. So let's first understand how would we define this term brand loyalty. See, when we talk about brand loyalty in terms of a definition given by American Marketing Association, it says that the degree to which a consumer consistently purchases the same brand within a product class. So basically, when you win the customer and customer has become loyal towards the product of your particular brand, then that particular process will be called as brand loyalty, right? Here you have won the customer, and the customer every time when going to will go to purchase that particular product or service or a particular category of product or service, then that customer will all time is going to opt for the product produced and sold by your brand in the market. So this is brand loyalty. Another definition, the situation in which a consumer generally buys the same manufacturer originated or produced product or service repetitively over the time rather than buying from multiple suppliers within the category. So when repetitively the customer is purchasing the product or service of a particular category from one particular brand or from one particular company, right? So instead of buying it from multiple suppliers or multiple companies, the customer is going to prefer only one particular company. So in that case, we call it as brand loyalty. Now again, one more definition is there. I have tried to put lot of definitions and meaning so that it is very clear to you in your mind that what do we actually mean by the concept of brand loyalty. So it is when a customer it has become totally faithful towards your brand and is continuously buying, solely buying the product or the service which is being sold by you, right? Rather than any pressure being applied from the organization. So here you as an organization or you as a brand, you are not trying to pressurize the customer to purchase the product of your brand. In fact, you have won the customer, and customer has automatically become faithful. And that faithfulness is reflected when the customer is preferring a particular category of product or service which that customer had experienced or bought earlier and is happy. So customer is coming again and hitting you. That means that is a loyal customer for your brand. So it is a plan of consumer behavior through which consumers generally tend to get committed to a specific brand or product and make repetitive purchases over the time. Loyal customers try to search multiple stores for their preferred brands. So if a customer is situated at a particular geographical location, or suppose for instance the geographical location of a customer has changed, so here a loyal customer will not change the brand immediately or will not take a decision immediately of switching the brand, but in fact a loyal customer would try to find out some stores at that new geographical location of customers, right? And more likely to forego their purchase in case the brand is not available. And also if the customer does not get the stores of your particular brand in the new geographical location of the customer, then customer might drop purchasing that product and would not very easily switch the brand, right? So this is how the process of brand loyalty goes on. Those who are loyal customers to a particular brand do not like to purchase a substitute brand in case the preferred brand is unavailable. If actually a customer is loyal to you, right, so then that customer would like to wait would like to find out solutions that how that product, that brand product can be available to me, right? So if in any cases or during some situations the product is not available for a particular period of time or due to some situation, then that loyal customer will be happy to wait instead of quickly switching the brand. So brand loyalty is the result of consumer behavior and is affected by a person's preferences. When consumers become committed to a brand and make repetitive purchases over time, that is called as brand loyalty. Loyal customers will continuously purchase products from their preferred brands only, and they will not take into the aspect that if there is some kind of discomfort or inconvenience, if they are going for a particular brand, they will be happy to face that inconvenience or discomfort for a short period of time, but their main intention is that I want to buy, I want to spend my money on the product of that particular brand, right? So that is actual loyal customer for you and for your brand. Companies often use different marketing strategies to cultivate loyal customers, be it through loyalty programs or reward programs. So winning the customers or loyal customers is a slightly different, tough task. For that, time to time the companies want or use some loyalty programs, but this is for a small period of time or for a shorter period of time. Once the customer has become loyal to you, then again and again the brand does not have to use the loyalty programs over the customers. Then when your customers have the opportunity and good reason, good solid strong reason to choose another brand, and yet they continue to choose your brand, that is actual brand loyalty, or you can categorize those customers as actual loyal customers towards your brands. When they have lot of options in front of them of products of same category offered by different brands, still they are preferring yours and not taking the decision of switching the brand, that condition or process is actually the brand loyalty. Now let's talk about five useful metrics while measuring brand loyalty: trust, customer satisfaction, goodwill, perceived quality, brand value. See, you need to win the trust, you need to satisfy your customer, you need to build a good goodwill in the market for your brand, then you need to deliver ultimate quality that is set in the mind of customer, whatever customer is expecting in regard to quality. The perception of the customer, which has been framed in the mind in regards to quality, you have to deliver that, and you need to think about the brand value. Now, when we talk about measuring brand loyalty with surveys, the first metric says customer satisfaction, right? When you are talking about customer satisfaction, you need to understand certain aspects for that, and those aspects are related to customer expectations, because until unless as a brand, as a company, you are not aware what are the expectations of my customer, you will not be able to satisfy your customer. So you need to ask certain questions, right? Like, how convenient is our company to use, or how convenient are the products of our company to use? How well do our customer service representatives answer your queries or solve your queries or listen to your concerns or issues? How likely are you to recommend us to other people, right? Then compared to our competitors, when we talk about the product quality, is our product quality better in comparison to our competitors? So these are some of the questions which when you can ask to customers in regard to providing them satisfaction as a customer. Second metric, we'll talk about trust. So here you need to ask certain questions again, right? Like, you need to assess the level of trust about how does the customer feel regarding your brand. Now the questions involved here can be: do you trust our brand? How did we earn your trust? How do we keep your trust? Right? So these are certain questions when we talk with the metric 2, that is the trust aspect. Then esteem or goodwill. this is very important, right? In order to attract the customer for a particular brand, right? So it may not be, in fact, be very well regarded. Brand esteem is about the favorable sentiment towards a brand in the market, in the eyes or the minds of the customers. So the questions related to goodwill can be, have you heard of our brand before? That means, are the customers actually familiar about your brand? How well do you know about your brand? Again, familiarity question. How positive do you regard our brand? Then here you're talking about the esteem of the brand. Do you prefer our brand over our competitor? Again, an esteem question. So these are certain questions which you can ask your customers in regard to the goodwill of your brand. Then we talk about the metric 4 and 5 that says perceived quality and brand value. So here a customer's perceived or perception in regard to the quality of the product sold by your brand, you need to take your opinion about the products and services. What do the customers have, right? So here you can ask certain questions like, how reliable would you consider our brand, or how reliable are the products of our particular brand? How would you rate the quality of the products which our brand is selling in the market? Closely related is perceived value, which is a consumer's opinion of a product's value for him or her specifically. For example, if we talk about Telsa Motors as a brand that produces innovative, attractive electric vehicles that amaze and delight and would rate perceived quality quite high. However, if that same person considers the price tag to be a bit too steep, the perceived value might be low for her or him in that specific case. So here you are talking about the brand value in terms of perceived quality. So that were the different metrics which we discussed today. Let me give you a quick overview. In today's class, we discussed about brand loyalty. We discussed four definitions of brand loyalty. So it is basically a pattern of consumer behavior through which consumers tend to get committed to a specific brand or product and make repetitive purchases, and they do not quickly switch to other brands even if the opportunities of purchasing the products served by other brands are available. So that is the ultimate loyal customer for your brand. Then we also discussed about the meaning and concept of brand loyalty. I have also tried to put some pictures in this regard. And then we discussed about the five main metrics used for measuring the brand loyalty, that is the trust, customer satisfaction, goodwill, perceived quality, and brand value. So when we talk about customer satisfaction, certain questions are to be asked which will help a brand to understand in general that how your products and services are meeting or exceeding the customer expectations. Then when we talk about the trust aspect, you need to retain the trust of your customers so that you ensure loyalty. But trust is especially important for brands that handle sensitive information such as banks, online retailers, healthcare providers, etc. Then we talk about the third metric, that is the esteem or goodwill. This is customers' respect for and attraction to a particular brand. It's not to be confused with brand awareness or familiarity, which is the level of recognition of a brand. While a brand might be well known, it may not in fact be well regarded. Brand esteem is all about the favorable sentiment about and towards your brand. Now, last two metrics are perceived quality and brand value. Here, a customer's perceived quality of a brand is their opinion of a particular product's service or brand's ability to fulfill his or her expectations. So this is what we discussed in today's class. And we'll be discussing, let me give you an overview about what we'll be discussing in our next lecture. We'll be talking about certain brand strategies, which may include product line, product strategy, line strategy, range strategy, and umbrella branding strategy. So we are done with brand loyalty and the various measures. So basically the five metrics which are used as measures to assess the brand loyalty of a company, of an organization. I hope you are getting what I am teaching. I also try to put certain pictures, certain images related to the topic which we are discussing in that particular lecture, so that those pictures and images can serve in understanding the concept of that particular term easily. So we'll be meeting again in the next lecture with new topics. Till then, thank you and take care.